Hello students, today in this video session I will start the new topic, the new chapter, which is MySQL, MySQL revision tool. This chapter you are already aware, we had already studied in standard 11th about MySQL and many topics, many queries regarding that. Today we will see first of all what is database and how it is related with MySQL. So let us first start with this, that is, what is database? So database is a organized collection of data about any entity or things. It is an collection of organized collection of data. It can be considered as the repository for the stored data. Repository for the stored data means the data will be stored in centralized place. Okay. So databases allows their user to enter, access and analyze their data quickly and easily. The database you have stored the information regarding any entity. Maybe the entity will be the teacher, maybe the entity will be the school, maybe the entity will be the student, maybe the entity will be any organization. Okay, the entity can be any things which exist. Okay, so that particular information which you have stored in the database, if you want to enter another information into the database, if you want to access the information, if you want to analyze your data quickly and easily, then you can do so with the help of databases. So database, so these all the were the definition of database. Now if the question will be, what is database system? Then database system is a computer based record keeping system. Here also the data will be stored, the data will be recorded, but database system, whenever the term system will be there, it will be computer based record keeping system. And when the DBMS term will be there, DBMS means database management system, then database management system is a computer program which is designed to manage a database. Manage a data means to enter an information, to delete the information, to access the information, many kind of work, whichever you will do in the database, that is known as to manage the database. And it provides a centralized control of the data. This is one of the very important thing regarding the database management system or DBMS, that all the information are centrally located, all the information are centrally placed. Therefore, there is a centralized control of the data. So these terms were very important for 1 or 2 mark question. So we will see now what is the advantage of DBMS. The advantage of DBMS, first one and the very important on the common one, is controlling the data redundancy. You have already seen in standard 11th in MySQL, before the MySQL there were the term DBMS. So it controls the data redundancy. Data redundancy means duplication of data, repetition of data. So using the database, redundancy gets controlled. So what you will write under this point, you can see, duplication of data leads to wastage of storage space. Okay, when the same information will be stored, then what will happen? There will be the wastage of the memory. So in DBMS, each data item is stored at only one place. In DBMS, each data item is stored at only one place in the database. So data redundancy eliminates, okay, it eliminates by integrating the files so that multiple copies of the same data are not stored. It eliminates the data redundancy, and multiple copies of the same data is not going to store with the help of DBMS. Second advantage is data consistency. This is the example of advantage of DBMS, that it data consistency. So DBMS provides data consistency to a large extent. Okay, and as the changes made at one place, because the data on the data there is a centralized control, therefore the changes will be at that very place where the data are stored and the centrally located place, and that are reflected at all other places or to all the users, the different application programs, whichever will refer, they will be getting the modified result, the changes result, because there are centrally located data are stored over there. There are the centralized control on the data. So whatever changes will be made, that will be made at one place, and rest of the users will be referred by that very centralized control of the data. So the changes will be reflected in other files or other users or other places too. Next advantage is data sharing. DBMS, database management system, facilitates sharing of data. That is, DBMS implies that not only existing applications can share the data in the database, but also that new applications can be developed to operate against same stored data. It means that the data sharing is possible not only for existing application, but whichever, if the new application is going to be developed, there also the data is easily shared. Next point, database enforces standards. With centralized control of the database, the DBA is the database administrator. So because there is a centralized control, therefore the database administrator can ensure that database administrator or DBA can ensure that all applicable in standards are followed in the representation of the data, because there are the centralized location for storing the data. Therefore the DBA ensures that the all the applicable standards should be followed by the in the representation of the data, that is the format of the data, the documentation standard and convention, etc. must be followed. Next point is privacy and security. Privacy and security is very important point regarding the advantage of DBMS. So data security means the protection of data against accidental or intentional access by unauthorized persons. Data should be protected by unauthorized users. Since there is a centralized control, therefore the data would be protected. The data is protected because of the centralized control on the data in the DBMS. And next advantage is improved data integrity. Improved data integrity refers to the validity and consistency of stored data. Validity and consistency of the stored data. For example, the system itself checks for the correct information to be entered by the user in the correct format. It consists of various constraints. It means that whenever you will be going to store any information while creating the table or the relation, then the system automatically checks that the data is correct or validated or not. Means the data should be valid and correct. If you will input or enter incorrect data or invalid data, then and there it will give you the error, or it will produce you the message that this particular data is wrong, you cannot enter this data. So why and how the data integrity will be maintained? By using this constraint. By using the constraint, by applying the constraint on the data validity and the data correctness will be followed. So these were the different points regarding the data ridden and regarding the advantages of the database, and all the advantages, all the points along with the explanation is very much important, not only for your board examination, but whenever in any of the field the questions will be related to DBMS, related to database, this point will be very important to along with the explanation. Next we will see how we will create the database practically, and how in the table we will create the, how we will create the table in the database, so that you can start and you can recall the things what you have learned in standard 11th. So let us move to the how we will open the MySQL. So here under the search box we will write for MySQL. If MySQL is already stored, we will write only simply my, then it will come here and we will click on MySQL command line. So as soon as you will click on MySQL command line, you will see that the MySQL command line window, the black screen is open for you. Now here the cursor will blink and ask you about the password and what password you had given while installing the MySQL that we need to that you need to give. So I have given my password as root, so I will write root here. As soon as the password will match, it will give you the message as welcome to the MySQL monitor and so and so. And very important thing is that MySQL prompt will be coming and the cursor will be blinking. That means the MySQL is ready to accept the command and to execute the command. Okay, and very first thing here we will write as create. First of all, we will see is there any database created or not, because we have to create the table. What we will do in MySQL, we will store the information, we will store the organized collection of data. So because we have to store the information, so what you need to do is you need to create the table, because in the table only, in the relation only, you will store the information in the form of rows and column. So but the table will not be going to create if directly you will create here, like I am creating create table. Suppose the table name is student. If I am creating and pressing the enter key, then the error is coming as no database selected, means we haven't selected any database. So very important thing regarding the MySQL is that you need to first create the database and then you create the table into that database. So here first of all we will see, before creating it, that is there any database available in my system by writing the command show databases, and the semicolon is statement terminator that you need to give. Yes, as soon as you have pressed the enter key, the output, the command is executed and it is showing here the databases whichever has created. So this word sys, performance schema, MySQL information schema, whatever I have told just now, the name of the databases are the system generated database. Okay, you are not supposed to use this very database for creating the table. You have to create the database if the test database is available here, or if you have created your own database, there only you create the table. Okay, you don't use this very database which is the system generated, like information schema, performance schema, MySQL, sys world. Okay, so you can use either Kerli or Sakila, but I want to create my own database so that I will keep all my tables into that very database. Therefore you will create the database using the command create database, and then after you will write the name of the database. So create space database space and the database name, any database name you write. I am writing here as class 12, and at last put the semicolon because it is a statement terminator. Why it is showing here error? You just read the error as you have an error in SQL syntax, check the manual for right syntax to use near 12. Okay, it means that I have given the one space over here, and as the variable name doesn't have any, variable name should not have any space. So here also, while creating the table or while creating the database can't have space. You can see here information, then space is not there, underscore is there. So you can write or put the underscore here, but not the space. So again, I will be writing this very command. But you will not write the command, you will use up arrow key from the keyboard. So as I am using up arrow key, I am pressing up arrow key. As soon as I will press up arrow key, just now whichever statement or command I have executed, that will come automatically. Look at here. See, I have pressed the Apero key and create database class 12th has come, because just now we have executed this very statement. So what we need to do is we need to remove this vary space, and I have written create database class 12 and then semicolon and press enter key. See, the message has come now. Query okay. Whenever query okay, one row affected will come. That means that command executed and the database is created. If I want to see that my database is created or not, or this database is in the list of this very database or not, we will apply this very command, show database. So again I will write apero key, then what command will come? Create database class 12 will come, and if again I'll press it, then show database will come, because the first command is this one and the previous one is show databases. So either you type directly the command, or if you don't want to type the command, you have already executed it, then you need to press the up arrow again and again. Yes, it has come now, because the just previous one was create database, then again create database class 12, and afterwards it is the show database. So it has come by pressing thrice the up arrow key and then press enter key. Now you can see class 12 has come into the list of the database. So this has come as the first name of the database. Why? Because it arranged the information in ascending order. Okay. After creating the database, the first task is using the database, means opening the database, because we want to create the table, and that very table should be inside any of the database. And under which database I want to create? I want to create the table under class 12. So class 12 should be opened by giving the command use one space class 12. As soon as the command executed, database changed message has come. That means now you are in which database? Class 12 database. Now whichever command you will apply, that will be under this particular database class 12. Clear? Cursor is blinking here. It means it is ready to accept the command. And why we have created the database? So that we can create the table. Now I will write the statement for creating the table. Suppose I want to store the employee information. There is an employee in an organization, and I want to store the all employees information into the table, in the form of table. So we will create the table named employee, and the command will be create table. Okay, create table, and what is the name of the table we want to give? That is employee. Create table employee. And many of you are in the habit of putting the semicolon, and you will be telling that the table is created. You will be thinking that the table is created, but it is a blunder. It is a mistake, because we want to create the table to store the information of the employee. So we should have the name of the field. We should have the name of the column where the employee's information will be stored. Therefore, we will first of all tell that the name of the column of the employee. So while pressing the enter key, as soon as you will press the enter key, you will see one arrow is coming. So you will write, and the column name you will specify under this very bracket. And the first field or the first column which I want to give it as employee number. No space, no dot, nothing. Underscore you can give. So employee number, we want to make it as one field. After the name of the field, you will specify its data type. It is must. Which type of, or what will be the type, which type of information you will be storing into the employee number? Will it be the character type of value? Will it be the number type of value? Which type of value? So employee number is a number type of value, that means the integer value. So either you write integer full or simply int. And you will specify the size here, the limit, means employee number will be of 4 digit or 5 digit or maximum what digit the employee number can contain in any in that very organization. Suppose it is of maximum 5 digit number, then you will be writing the limit or size as 5. It means that you are providing the employee number maximum limit 5 digit. It cannot be more than 5 digit, it can be less than 5 digit, it can be equal to 5 digit, but it can't be more than that. Okay, so column name, data type, size. If you want to put the constraint, then you can put it, or if you don't want to put any constraint, you can leave it. But it is always a better choice that you put the constraint. So constraint I am taking as primary key for the employee number. That employee number column we want to make it as a primary key. There is a should be space between primary and key. So first column definition is over by writing the name of the field, data type, its size, and after specifying the constraint, and then put the comma. Press enter key. Second field I want to create as employee name, EMP name, and name I should be the character type of value. So here string data type will not be used, either you will use the char or varchar. So I am using here as varchar variable character length, and maximum limit for the employee name, suppose I am writing here at 15 character, means employee number maximum limit I have provided as 15 character. Constraint if you want to put, then you can put. Generally we put the constraint not null for the name sort of field, means that employee name must have the value in each of the rows. Next field I want to keep it as designation. What will be the designation of the employee, or what is the designation? Designation will also have the data type as varchar. So always you have to write the column name first, then the data type, then the size or the limit, and if any constraint, then constraint. Here also I am putting, I don't want to put any constraint here, so you just simply leave it by putting the comma. And the next salary, it is should be integer, and the maximum digit for the salary, suppose I am writing it as 7. Okay, and then after this only 4 column I want to create, and then you have to close this very bracket which you have opened here, it should be closed, and the statement terminator semicolon. As soon as I will press enter key, if this very statement or command does not have any error, the table will be created. Now I am pressing the enter key. Query OK comes, it means command executed successfully. Okay, you want to check that your table is created or not into the database class 12, then what we will do, we will write the command show tables semicolon. So show tables, when you will give the command, then tables in class 12. Class 12 is what? The name of the database. So what table is there in class 12? Employee. Okay, so when you will use the show databases, when you will use show table, it should be clear in your mind. You are not supposed to confuse that where you will issue the command show table and when we will use the show databases. Okay, now suppose I want to check, is there any table in Sakila database? How you will give? You are now in class 12 database, so you need to change the database, and changing the database is use which database you want to use. Sakila, I have written Sakila semicolon, database change, that means we are now in the database Sakila. We have come out from this class 12 and now we are in Sakila. You want to see the table, that is there any table or not in the Sakila database, you will write show tables. You will write show tables and put the semicolon here. Suppose by mistake you have pressed the enter key and you have forgotten to press the semicolon, don't worry, you can press it here. Yes, tables in Sakila is this all. Many tables are there. How many tables? You can see 23 rows. 23 means 23 tables are there in the Sakila database. Okay, so in this way you will create the table as well as the database. Again, I want to move to the our database which I have created as class 12. So you will move it there by using the command. Okay, the table you which you have created, you want to see the structure, that what type of informations are stored in employee. You can write it here as DSC employee or describe employee. See, employee table, just now what we had created, employee number, employee name, designation, salary, the type is int 5, varchar 15, int null, key is there, employee number, I have created the primary key, default value is not specify, extra column doesn't have any meaning here. So four rows in a set means there are four columns. In which table? In the employee table. And this employee table is under which database? Class 12. Suppose I will change this database and I will write here use Kerali. Which all database were there? Sakila, I suppose I want to make it use Sakila. And I want to write DESC employee. Will this command will execute? Error colon in place of semicolon. I have provided the colon. Table Sakila employee does not exist. Yes, because I have created the employee table under the database class 12 and I am checking it under the Sakila. So this error is coming as table Sakila employee. Sakila employee means the database Sakila dot employee does not exist. It is not there because these are the name of the file under the, these are the name of the table under the Sakila. As you can see here, actor, actor info, these all are the name of the table. So in this way you will do the practical of MySQL. So MySQL select queries, DSC, then rest, lot of condition, how it will be written, which is the part of the MySQL revision tour which you need to do. So for today's only this much. The next class I will tell you more about this, more about the practical as well as what is MySQL and what are the different categories of the language, SQL languages. Okay, till then you revise the topic. Goodbye.